Welcome friends. Now this is the, I think, our third video on teaser or overview of this business. Now we have seen into the first one, what is indenting, what is in general definition, and what is indented, and also how this business is lucrative. In the second video, you have seen what is this course will cover and what are the benefits of indenting, and how you should list the products, 25 products, and 5 products you will try to make the research in deep, and you will launch this product, and every year you will add upon 5 products, 2 and several verticals, and this your add-on income will come. Now in this particular episode, I want to tell what are the do's and don'ts of indenting business, or rather this is applicable to any business, import or export, reverse indenting, or even a local business what you are doing already currently. Because these are the general kind of important tips or factors you should do or you should avoid, right? So these do's and don'ts of indenting business: don't ever enter into the market unless your market research is totally over. Means what is demand, supply, and what are the products existing, what is going to be competition, who are going to be our customers, which are the applications, which are the suppliers, how many suppliers you should have, how many customers. So all this deep market research is required, and once you have this targeted research is over, and you will screen the product whether we should go ahead or we should not go ahead, and then we launch the product. So before doing this in-depth study, you never ever get into the business, otherwise you will be a big flop, or you will face some problem, or your knowledge is half-heartedly, and the business will not succeed. Never ever give any credit to back any order for getting into the business. So when you have a total foolproof things ready available, and then you go for the order and don't give any credit, or either if you give the credit against letter of credit or bank guarantee or any kind of collateral checking, after that only you give the business, which may be a different case. Into the local market, you are first giving against delivery or immediate payment, then it gets delayed to 30 days, then 60 days. I have seen many companies are giving the credit up to 360 days. That means the buyers are really using your product and also the finance, and they are earning the money, and you are just continuing, and you are stuck up into the vicious cycle. So you need to get out of this stuck up cycle. So this product, you will never ever give any open credit, right? Never compromise on quality or specification. Whatever the buyer requires, you try to comply as far as possible, 100%, or even you can give better than that product, and you can give the price accordingly. Suppose you are not able to get into up to 100% level, you can mention to the buyer that okay, we can give 99.8%, 99.5%, or 99%, or 98%, and this is what we can do. Let us be very transparent to the supplier, from supplier end to the customer end, and let the buyer knows it, and let him decide if you want to buy. So that means you don't carry any hidden agenda on behalf of supplier or on your behalf or any buyer's behalf. The buyers will say that okay, you get the offer, then we'll see. If they are not pretty sure about it or any product what they are getting, if they have the specs available or what kind of material or application they want, then only you seriously pursue to the supplier, right? So no compromise on that. Never ever encourage supplier and buyers to get into the performance only when you are going to get the big orders. Even a sample order is very important for you, and even the big order is important for you. And because you have done the sample order very well, it doesn't mean that you will delay the shipment or you will do any kind of thing. So you go to the world-class suppliers, you go to the world-class customers. Since maybe if your home country is India or Dubai or US or Canada, the best of the suppliers in your country, so please offer those products for the exports from your home country, or when you import from another country, you give the best kind of product. You have to remain into the premium market. See, always there is a room at the top. So don't get into the very low cost product. If the low cost product with the high quality is also available due to the mass production, then it's okay. Otherwise, never get into lower quality of the product or follow any agenda which is not good for anybody. The deals are as far as possible with the top of the line supplier and top of the line of the customer. And you need to position this product into different application, and you can go with this product to the different countries. The deal has to be done with the commitment and integrity. As an indenter, as a mediator, as a consultant, you will have to work as a committed person and with the total integrity to benefit both the party. You may be getting your overriding commission or consulting fees from the supplier, or sometimes you can get it from the buyer if the product is scarce or buyer want a specialized product. But even though you are getting from one party, then you don't try to only represent on their behalf. In the sense, you will have to comply to the quality requirement of the buyer also. So you need to be very, very clear on that part, right? Then deal with the and decide the supplier and customer to route through you only. You better tell them that you go through me only, because if you try to bypass me, then I'm not responsible. Because normally there is a lot of ego clash between the buyer and the supplier, and we are as a buffer. We know where to lower down, where to go up, as with the supplier or a buyer, or you can try to persuade the buyer or a supplier to accept some price or accept some payment term or accept some quality which is not going to be available, because we are going to the best suppliers in the world, or in your home country you are going to the best supplier in your country. So there will not be many suppliers giving this kind of even quality. So that is most important. Then you have to need to ask the buyer and supplier to perform whatever the dates have been given, whatever the payment has to be done in time with the buyer side, or supplier has to ship within the same month, then he has to supply in the same month and give the proper document, not the discrepant document. So all these things you will have to study before going into the market, right? So these are do's and don'ts. Even if you don't do business certain time or with the certain buyer, no problem. Till you get the best buyer, till you get the best supplier, you are not going to go ahead. But once you go ahead and your study is deep, suppose you are going to do a product of 100 units to sell, then how many units of the customers you should require? How many suppliers you should require? All this we are going to cover here. But do's and don'ts are very important. If you follow this line of business or these very important things in the process, then I think you will be 100% successful like me. So thank you very much. So see you in the course, and please see our two videos if you have not seen before, and then all the best. Thank you very much.